Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue once again from the Shotgun Team, and here's our video tip for today and our 30 tips in 30 days. This one's going to focus on some hotkeys you can use. I like to call it type where you want to go. The point of this is to easily navigate to what you're trying to do. Now there's a lot of different options you have when you come to different fields and cells and so on is this, and you right click on something such as sequence right here. I'll right click on it and I get a flyout. Now if I want to navigate to, say, configure this field, I can just type C, and you'll see now configured field is highlighted. If I hit the return or the enter key, the field name dialog box is going to appear, and I can then change and update the field. Let me choose cancel for that. I'll go back to my sequence option once again as an example. I right click on that and we want to go to group. I'll type G and now group is highlighted and its options in a flyout are available to me. Now keep in mind where my cursor is right now. It is still hovering above the column's name sequence. So if I hit the A key, I go to my advanced sorting. Now if I bring my cursor down to where it's highlighted over the group flyout and I choose A, I'm going to highlight add to advanced grouping. So the hotkey of typing the different name of where you want to go or what you want to select is relevant to where your cursor is over. If I hit S right now, nothing's going to happen because there is nothing in this flyout that starts with the letter S. If I bring my cursor back over the column's name sequence and I hit S, sort ascending is going to be available. Now, what if I want to actually highlight and access the summary? Well, then just start typing it, SU, and Shotgun is going to find the name that you are typing. Again, if I hit H, I now choose hide column. I hit return, that column is now hidden. Now, if I expand my fields flyout and we scroll down, you can see we've got lots of different options in here. And this is a great example of where you have multiple fields with the same name. Cut duration, cut in, cut order, cut out. So if I wanted to go to cut out, I would just type, including the space, cut out. So I type cut, space, out, and I go to that entity. I hit return. I now add the cut out field to my columns. Description is taking a lot of space, so let me highlight that, hit H, and hit return to get rid of that. All right, let me expand our column options here. And you have the same workflow for all these submenus we have down here. It's the same idea. Whatever my cursor is over and there is a flyout and I start to type something, it is going to select the element inside the flyout that matches what I'm typing. So if I type end, we go to end date. If I type last, I go to last accessed. If I start typing the word created, create by is then selected. Now if I bring my cursor over created by flyout and I go to person, I have a whole nother selection in this flyout. I type ID, that is highlighted, I hit return. The project created by person ID has now been added as one of my columns. So this has been a really quick short tip, but it's a very powerful one that allow you to get to where you want to go by simply typing its name. 30 tips in 30 days.